My poor hair needs to be actually done. Like I need to take a moment and curl it or something, but not right now. Look how cute. Warning, what you're about to witness is extremely extra. Fudge. Okay. It's an antler. Oh, but it's backwards. I mean, it's Vlogmas, so it doesn't really matter, right? You know, this definitely looked cuter in my head.
We're feeling festive. Yeah, isn't that amazing? In Christmas times, we'll be chilling and having a good, good time. Doesn't matter if the snow is falling.
My outfit is concerning. So Duncan got fixed yesterday and he refused to go to the bathroom until this morning because if he has that cone on, he will not pee outside. So I had to take it off because I needed him
to urinate.
I had to put it back on myself and I did not do it right, but it's the effort. Good morning, starting with liquid IV. I am dead. We're gonna be very real and honest today because as fun as Vlogmas is, I'm struggling. And I'm sure Andrew and Gerald and my mom are tired of hearing me talk about Vlogmas and they just want me to shut up. But boy, oh
boy,
I have not been taking care of myself the past like 2 weeks. Vlogmas is the best thing in the entire world and I look forward to it every single year, but it is so much more work than you guys might think. I'm not saying that to complain. I just think that I need a chill day and I still have a lot of work to do today. It's supposed to storm, so we're probably going to be stuck inside for most of the day. It's already like 12:30. It hasn't started snowing yet, but when I say it's supposed to snow, like it's supposed to snow. It's supposed to be at least 12 inches of snow. All it's done is snow for the past 7 days, so I don't know how much more snow we can possibly get. Before you comment,
Samantha, it's okay to take a break. It's okay if we need to skip a day.
No, it's not. I understand that the job I have is very lenient and I get to decide when I work and how often I post, but Vlogmas is a commitment that I make to you guys. I am not missing a day. That is just simply not an option. It's not an option. I don't even want it to be an option. Like I said, I'm not saying this to complain. I'm just saying I'm hitting the middle of Vlogmas. The beginning of Vlogmas is easy because it's new and fun and exciting and you have so much to talk about and so much to say. The end is fun because it's Christmas, but right now, I'm still alive, but I'm barely breathing. But that's also the beauty of it because I don't have to do anything exciting and you guys get to see what life is actually like. So this morning I woke up and filmed my whole morning for a morning routine video because I figured that also might give me a little time to breathe and got my coffee.
I got my little recovering boy over here. Tell them how mean mommy is.
She got your balls taken away.
Tell them how hard your life is.
His ears are so big. Look at him all his ears back. I feel so bad for him. It's just how the cookie crumbles, my dude. I'm finally gonna cook a meal today. I made breakfast this morning, but I'm just, I don't know how to explain all of the feelings that I'm feeling to you. He can twerk. I need to go to Ulta, get more shampoo and conditioner, and I wanna get some more lipstick shades because now that I have luscious lips. I know I said like I wasn't sure about my lips. I think it looks pretty good now. I could use a little more, but don't worry. Not Trisha. So we have to go to Ulta and we're gonna make food and we're gonna hang out, play in the snow. Yeah, that's all I can think of. It's a little bit later now and it's snowing. I don't know if you can even tell, but that's quite a bit. I should probably shovel their porch so it doesn't like fall down. That's a thing in case you never thought of it. I have a fire going because it makes me happy. Yes,
I've been crying, but I'm pretty sure you figured that out by now.
Duncan is looking at me like, bitch, I'm the one with a cone on my head, and you don't see me crying.
If I'm being honest, I'm not really sure why I'm crying. I'm getting my period, I guess. But Snickers won't let me give her fluid, and I have to edit. And I don't know what to film anymore. And I don't want to let you guys down, even though I know your standards are really low. That wasn't aggressive, but you guys always say you would watch me stare at a wall. And I've tested it, and you guys watched it. I just think I'm getting overwhelmed. I just need to relax or something. But I keep telling myself to relax so much, but I'm not actually relaxing. And I think I just needed to cry.
Can you be quiet? Can you just be there without crackling?
I don't know. I've decided I'm making meatloaf for dinner, and I've never made a meatloaf before. So that also gives me anxiety. I need my therapy session stat. Instead of letting myself feel, I overwork, I overworry, and I let my anxiety bottle up until I crack. It's okay to not be okay. Let's just sit down, actually. We haven't had an emotional chat this Vlogmas yet because I'm pretty stable. That's me lying to myself. I need to pull myself together because the snow started and I absolutely need to go to the store to get shampoo. Let's just quick chat. Sometimes I feel like, I don't know, maybe other creators feel this way or maybe just people in the entertainment business, maybe other career fields too and I just haven't experienced them. But like sometimes I feel like I'm only alive for the purpose of other people. When it's just me and my own thoughts and myself, like I love who I am, but I struggle to comprehend why anyone would want me around. Or like I'm only useful to people when I can give them something or to entertain, and like I know I'm so much more than that. But when I have my little moments, that's typically one of the big things that's at like the forefront. Everyone struggles with different things. As much as it sucks, it's so normal, but it's exhausting sometimes. I really am considering medicine to try and control my mind because I work so hard to be better and to not think the way I think and to not have anxiety over everything. I've been doing exposure therapy for a while, and yes, I'm able to do more, but the anxiety is still there. I just don't let it cripple me anymore. It might seem stupid and it might be something you can't understand, and that's okay, but I really want to not worry all the time. I want to not have a voice in my head that's constantly telling me that I'm not good enough, that I'm always gonna mess up. I've grown a lot in the past year, but I feel like I miss a lot about the person I used to be. But then again, I don't even know who that was. Sometimes I just feel like I'm an empty shell of a person and I'm just existing, and it comes in waves. Some days I feel great and I'm so happy, and other days I just don't really feel like existing. So many people say, but you're so loved, like so many people love you and you have so many great things going for you. But like my brain does not let me enjoy any of them. It doesn't let me enjoy the fact that every single day there's 100,000 of you showing up to spend the day with me. Like I'm the least lonely person in the world because of all of you guys. And my brain doesn't let me think that. I feel like a machine that is just working to please everybody. I don't know if anyone like knows me or like sees me. I try so hard to see everybody and then make everyone feel so special. I'm not saying people in my life don't give me that back, it's just I'm not able to feel it. The same way like my brain doesn't let me be happy that I have all of you. Maybe I'm just numb, but numb people probably don't cry. I don't know. I've just been really struggling the past couple days, and I've been trying to like mask it because I don't want Vlogmas to be sad, but I think something a lot of you guys really appreciated about Vlogmas in 2019 is just, I was just so raw. I wasn't afraid of the internet yet. And no, I'm not saying it's Vlogmas. It's just everything. I think what's gonna make me feel better is just realizing that I don't need to think so far ahead. We're just gonna live today, and then we're gonna wake up again and get through tomorrow. We will deal with life as it comes. And I don't know what's gonna happen in life, where I'm gonna live. I don't know who's gonna be in my life, but I know that I have me and my dog and my cats, my family, my friends, and everything will always work out. So, like I said, nothing happened, literally nothing, except me just getting very overwhelmed and very much in my own head. This is just me telling you, I know I'm not the only one out here struggling, so if you are also struggling with something, anything, we got you. Maybe you guys can leave some uplifting comments in the comment section. For me, something that helps me a lot is hearing that other people. I don't want to hear that you guys are struggling. Like, that makes me feel so bad. Like, I don't want you to struggle, but mental health can be such a lonely thing. and so many people don't talk about it. So many people also do talk about it, but I think there's too many people in the world that just say, smile, don't complain, you're being weak. So many things to put down mental illness. It is truly one of the most difficult things to go through. You want so badly to be okay, and you can be in therapy, you can be waking up every day trying your best to be better, and your brain just doesn't let you, and it feels like you're in a constant battle between yourself and your head. And some days I win and some days my brain wins, and today my brain is winning, but we're gonna turn that around and we're gonna have a good rest of our day. So cheers to the mentally unstable. You can barely see outside, that's how much it's snowing right now. I might have done some retail therapy in Ulta. I used to actually work at this Ulta, so when I come here, I always see so many people. But I finally met Carrie. If you guys haven't seen Carrie in the comment sections or you haven't like seen her videos, she is the sweetest woman. I don't even know, for years maybe? It's always been like,
oh. I wonder when we're gonna run into each other.
And she came out to me while I was in Ulta. I was on the phone, I would have vlogged with her, but she is the sweetest. Carrie, I absolutely love you. I get so awkward meeting people in person, so I hope it wasn't too weird, but she's really sweet and she has a YouTube channel, so you guys should check it out. I'll leave it down in the description. I always see so many sweet people when I'm in there, and honestly I kind of needed that because I was crying right before I left, but you already knew that. So let's see what I got. You might look at this bag and be like, that's a little bag. This is a big bag. Let's see. I probably won't show everything, but keep in mind, I have $448 in Ulta points right now. The Ulta Rewards program is next level. I got a bunch of lipsticks because I'm really excited to wear lipstick. New lips, new me. Kylie Jenner lip kit and Better Not Pout. I've heard good things about these Anastasia cream bronzers. Got one of those. This is the Stila like liquid eyeshadow in Kitten Karma. I used to be obsessed with these and I feel like it's very holiday. Like this with brown in the crease and a wing eyeliner.
Some lashes and like a dark red lip.
It's my Adele moment. If you're gonna leave me now. Two of the Kat Von D or whatever they're called now. What are they called now? I don't know. But I got these two colors. This is the one I'm most excited for. A Tarte Shape Tape, an Anastasia Stick Blush. I've been getting into creams recently. I got the big ones. These are the Pureology Hydrate Shampoo and Conditioners. They were $70 a piece. I'm obsessed with it. That's the only reason I went and bought the big one. But holy crap. I didn't realize it was that expensive until I was checking out. I also got their Strength Cure Miracle Filler Treatment. Little spray. They had a little Too Faced ornament that's the lip injection. Extreme. Gets lip injections, then goes to store and buys product that plumps lips. That's Andrew. Hello.
My stomach's bubbly.
Nice. Nice.
What else did I buy? Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation. I need some new makeup brushes, so I just got two sets. I got this green eyeshadow palette and this little lip balm set. Fit Me Foundation from Maybelline. I'm on Hair Talk, and every single girl that I see on Hair Talk always says that they wear satin sleep beanies to sleep. This is the one that they always use. It's the satin lined sleep beanie. And I'm trying to fix my hair because it's so damaged and so broken like my soul. So I got that. I'm a terror when I sleep, so it probably won't even stay on. It was worth a try. That's what I bought. The only thing I needed was shampoo and conditioner. I was crying today, I deserved it, you know? Okay, my lips actually look pretty good. I also still need to finish decorating my car. It's not doing it for me this year. Like, I need all the extra little twirlies on here. Like, this is cool. This is really cool, but it's not enough for me. Not enough. Toodaloo.